My name is Lauren with Lauren Elizabeth Fine Art, and if you're a creative and you want to improve your skills in animal art but you kind of don't know where to start, here's 5 tips for helping you to get started.
All right, the first tip I would definitely recommend is start with a great reference photo. If you're having trouble seeing any skin indents or whiskers or scales in your reference photo, then you're definitely going to have trouble drawing it and painting it. So what I recommend is having a reference photo where you can see the tiny details like nostrils and pupils and tiny whiskers. So if you can see that, it makes laying down the sketch much easier. And if you have a great sketch, that lays you out, sets you up for a great painting. Which leads me to tip number 2, which is practice your drawing. And I know if you're a beginner artist, this makes things a little tricky. You might have little to no experience drawing, but as you can see, what I do is I actually break it up into shapes. I really learned how to draw that way by using lots of circles and triangles and ovals. And when I'm able to place down the shapes, that makes the final sketch a lot easier. And when you have a great sketch, it makes painting so much easier and more fun. And that's the goal here, to have fun and come out with a great masterpiece. All right, so now you have your sketch. What do you do about the painting? Learn the basics of your medium before trying to tackle the details of any animal. How you paint the animal and the colors you lay down depends on the medium you're using and the type of animal. How you approach painting animals with acrylic paint versus watercolor or colored pencils is all going to be quite different. I tend to lean more towards acrylic paint just because it's fast and I love the bright colors. Now, I also teach watercolor and colored pencil and graphite pencil and marker, so there is a variety of different mediums that you can get to know and make the same animal with. So it just depends on the look that you're going for. So once you've learned just the basics of how to use your medium, then you want to make sure you have the proper tools. So that includes your paint, that includes your paint palette, and your brushes. All this information is listed in a PDF below, including the tools that I'm about to list. Now you do not have to buy expensive paint or brushes or anything like that. I am really one to save money. I am definitely a frugal artist, but there's definitely paint brands and brushes that I would recommend for any animal artist, even beginners. I have 3 brushes here that I would recommend. So to my left, you'll see 2 brushes. One's a micro detail brush and one's a flat brush. And the one I'm using in my hand is a regular small detail brush. Now I'm working on a smaller scale here, but these brushes help me to paint anything from backgrounds to nostrils to tiny little crevices to fur. There's different techniques that you can use with these brushes that allow you to paint all types of animals. Now when it comes to paint, having good quality paint is very important, but you don't need to buy the most expensive brands. So when it comes to acrylic paint, the paint brands that I recommend to my students are 1, Basics, 2, Master's Touch, probably my favorite, and then 3, a more expansive brand that has great color is Winsor & Newton. And the other things you'll need are a paper towel or a cloth, a cup for your water, could be a jar, glass jar, whatever. And then when it comes to your paint palette, I use this glass plate. It doesn't have to be fancy. You could even use a paper plate if you'd like. But if you're gonna continue to paint animal art, it might be something to invest in. This glass plate was actually only 10 bucks. So, like I said, you don't have to spend lots of money to create beautiful works of art. And last but not least, the canvases that I like to work on that I recommend for a beginner is cotton canvas. 100% cotton canvases can be very inexpensive at any craft store and definitely something that will probably cost maybe $10 for a bundle. And there's different sizes like 8x10, 11x14, 16x20. And last but not least, tip number 5 is try painting all types of animals. And I recommend painting animals with very little texture on their bodies. So, for instance, jellyfish or hippos or fish, they don't have a lot of fur or bumpy textures to their body. It's a little bit more sleek and it makes painting a lot easier. If you're a creative that really wants to learn how to paint all types of animals, including your household pets and wildlife, with a focus on acrylic paint, I actually have created an online animal art masterclass for artists of all levels, beginner through advanced. And all the tutorials that you've just watched are actually on this masterclass. Every month we explore all kinds of animals, like household pets, birds, reptiles, ocean life, farm animals, and while reducing stress. It's really designed for creatives who really want to grow in their strengths in animal art and just improve their mental health overall. I give students reference photos, a list of materials for each tutorial, and even traceable printouts if you're not a fan of drawing. So guys, if that's something you're interested in, along with the PDF that goes with this video with all the things that I've just listed, everything is down below. All right guys, I hope you found that helpful. If you have any questions, make sure you leave that in the comment section below and I'll get back to you right away. But I look forward to seeing you next week and the next video. What I have planned is something very furry and a painting tutorial using acrylics. So stay tuned. Bye.